to another monthly vlog. So we are about a week into the month and I have first decided now that I wanted to update you guys. So I had a pretty rough start to the month mentally and personally and stuff like that. There was a lot of things happening and I just think I got a mental breakdown, so that was also the reason why I didn't start the vlog completely as I used to do. So I have not been doing much. I've been going to school, which it cost a lot of energy and stuff like that, but I have been drawing a little bit. I'll maybe set some photos up here and there. And then I have been writing a little bit, and I have been reading. So I'm still reading Sword of Destiny by Andrzej Sapkowski, and I'm around the 50 page mark, so I'm not that far into it. I'm still enjoying. I think this short story, that this one is also a short story collection, that the one I'm reading currently is one of the weakest I have read from him, but I'm still not deterred about it. I really enjoy Andrzej Sapkowski's writing, so I'm sure that maybe it will pick up sooner or later. And I really don't like Yennefer that much, so I hope that changes too, because I love her in the games. So that I hope is going to change. The second book I'm currently also reading in is Daughter of Envy by Reni K. Amayo, I think that's pronounced, I don't know. And yeah, I'm not at chapter 8, so I'm not that far into it. I hope in this week I can get it to around the 100 page mark, but we will see. I'm for now I'm really enjoying it and I think it's very interesting. There are many words that's a little bit confusing, but there is a dictionary in the back, so I have a little help to find out what things is. So the third book I'm currently reading or listening to, I'm listening to audiobook, is The Wicked Saint by Emily A. Duncan, and I'm enjoying that one very much. It's an interesting story. I think I talked about it in the last vlog when I started the book, but that I'm fairly good into and I'm really enjoying it. And I'm enjoying the audiobook in a whole and stuff like that, so that's also a good thing. I have also decided that one of my own projects, this is a semi-animated project, is going to be something, and but it's still in the planning phase, so I'm still planning out how the story is going to go and the characters and all that stuff, and then I'm drawing a character to get more inspiration. I'm trying to keep myself creative, especially when I'm not feeling that well. I'm trying to get myself to be creative so I have something to distract me from. So that is Beta Immersion View. But this was the update I had for you. I will see you guys around. Hello, I'm back from the dead. I think it felt like that, surely. But it's been like 2 weeks since I updated, and because of that I had a kind of a mental breakdown for the past 2 weeks, and I'm finally getting up from the hole I dug myself, so that's nice, I guess. So I have around a week left of this month, so I thought why not just try to make the best of this vlog, if I can even call it that, I don't know. But I will here with a little bit of reading update. I have managed to finish one book, and that was the audiobook of The Wicked Saint by Emily A. Duncan. I gave that one 5 out of 5 stars. I'm still reading Daughters of Envy, and I'm not that far into it still. I'm almost at the 100 page mark, so that's always a thing. And then I'm still reading Sword of Destiny, And that one I have just managed to get to the 100 page mark, and so that is what I'm currently have been reading on. As I said, I didn't have much energy to do much reading or anything. I have been writing very little, and I have been drawing also very little. I have been drawing a few profiles for my characters because it seemed that drawing was the only thing I could do, so that's always a thing. So yeah, and what I have done for now, I have been uploading the August vlog I have been uploading, and I have been uploading a gameplay video on my other channel, so that I have been doing, and I think I also uploaded a speed paint, but I'm not quite sure if it was, I think that was before my mental breakdown. So yeah, that's basically it. I came to update today. I am going to draw a bit, I'm going to read a bit, then I'm going to plan some videos, yeah, try to relax and prepare for the next day where I'm going back to school. So I'll see you guys later. And this is the month of October, I think. Yeah, October. It became October after a long, long September where I did nothing. But that's another talk. I will start this video with a little bit of book mail. And I have two packages here, and I'm so excited for both of them. Why should you? Anyway. One I have already read and listened to an audiobook. Another one I have not read. Let's see. So beautiful. The Stolen Throne, a Dragon Age novel. So this book is based on the Dragon Age games, and this one is taking place before, I think some years before the first Dragon Age game or something like that. But it's beautiful. I have a little beautiful, beautiful cover, and that is why I choose to bite the bullet and spend more money, because these are beautiful, and it has deckled edges, which I love. I love deckled and thick pages too. Oh, the end pages, look at those, they're so beautiful. Oh my god, I don't regret buying this. Even if I'm not going to like it, I'm still buying it. Oh, they are illustrated too. Oh my god. They're beautiful. Even though I'm pretty sure I'm going to like it, but even though if I don't like it, I'll still keep it because I'm a massive Dragon Age fan. So I can read you a little about what this book is about. After the Queen of Realdom is betrayed and murdered, her son, Merrick, becomes the leader of a rebel faction struggling to free their nation from control of foreign tyrant. With few allies save Lohan, a brash young outlaw, and Roran, a fierce warrior, and his betrothed Merrick, must find a way to free Forelden from the clutches of the enemy and restore his family to the throne. And this one is written by David Gaider. So, beautiful, beautiful book. I'm looking forward to this. I think I'm going to save this one. Next one is the one I have already read, and I read or listened to the audiobook of this book in September, where I didn't vlog because mental health was a bitch. And here it is. Wicked Saint by Emily A. Duncan. It had deckled edges too. Oh my god, it's my birthday today. Seriously. And the end pages, they are so beautiful. Yeah. Let them fear her. that was one of the main reasons why I wanted the hardback version, because of the little feel. Oh, it's so beautiful. So this is about a blood mage prince and a girl who can speak with the gods, and they are in war with each other. For the girl, she's a cleric. There's on one of the side of the war, there's fighting against the blood mages and blood prince and stuff like that. And then a chance, there is a chance that the girl, I have forgotten her name actually, that's kind of Nadia, gets an opportunity to take down the king of the blood mages and stuff like that. And it's the journey so far, and then there's a monster too that I don't want to talk much about, but I love him. So, oh my god. Look at this. I'm gonna try to find the first chapter. And there's a beautiful map. And look at those chapter pages. They're so beautiful. Oh my god, I wish my book, when I once upon a million years published my own book, I have chapter pages like that. Oh my god. And this, so beautiful. I really, really love this, and I need to get the second book. I don't think that the audiobook for the second book is out yet, because then I have already read it. But I need to get the hardcover too. I can. So, it's so beautiful. I'm distracted right now, so I can't give. So, as I said, I read this one last month, and I gave that one 5 out of 5 stars. Yeah, there was some problematic things, but I really overall enjoyed the overall story. I enjoyed both, what's his name again? I have no idea what his name is. I've forgotten his name. 2 seconds. Seraphim was his name, and Nadia, I also really liked. Seraphim reminded me of Zuko from Avatar The Last Airbender, and I loved that show. The overall story actually gave me a reminder of Avatar The Last Airbender, and I really enjoyed the story. I enjoyed the monster also, the conflict the monster faced and stuff like that. So it's just really cool story, and I really, really recommend it. I need to find a place to have this book. I'm out of space. I shouldn't really buy any books anymore, but I can't help myself. When I'm sad, I buy books. I then started on another audiobook, and that one was The Last Night of Sarah by Christine Cicerelli. That one I finished too in the month of September, and I gave that one 3 out of 5 stars. Because of my mental health, I wasn't really able to read physically, not much at least, so I haven't done much progress in those two books I'm currently reading physically. But I started another audiobook, and that is The Stormcrow. I actually think... 2 seconds. The next audiobook I started was The Stormcrow by Katlyn Josephson. And this is about a kingdom where the kingdom is built up on these magical crows. But once they were destroyed, all hope has fallen. The kingdom was in despair, the nature is falling apart because no longer have these magic crows to keep it up. And then there's this princess, Anfia, who is really, really depressed over the loss of the crows, the loss of her mother and her teacher, until she finds a crow, storm crow egg, and determined with her sister to hatch it. Meanwhile, she's married off to the enemies, and it all goes on from there. Hello, welcome back. It's been like a little over a week since I made an update. I have been home by my parents for holiday, so I had planned some filming, but I didn't do any filming, so it was quite more that I try to relax a little bit this holiday, just because I have been very much up and down on the mental status, so I just thought I wanted to relax instead of filming that I had planned, though I have a good filming spot back at my parents' house, so I hope I can get to use it someday. But I'm here to give you a little bit of an update. I am currently working on a speed paint. I hope I have showed something like that before, and if not, future me, inset work in progress. Oh well, and I've been drawing a little bit, my hand hurt, but I'm still drawing. I don't think it's a good idea, but I do it anyway, so yeah, here we are. But the reading update. I have been reading a lot this holiday in The Daughters of Envy, and I'm over halfway through. This book I have been reading in is Sword of Destiny, and I just finished that story here the other day. And if you know the characters, you know. So I hate Istrid. That is just what I'm going to say. He's an asshole. And I don't like Yennefer. Maybe she will change. I don't think she will change, to be honest. But I don't like her very much. And Istrid, I just hate. He's a terrible man. And even though, yeah. Yeah, and Geralt, I just enjoy Geralt. He takes everything like a champ, and but I'm really enjoying it. I'm looking forward to read more. I will say that I enjoyed the first short story in this one much more than the second one, but I can see the meaning in the entire story in itself. It's just like that, but I enjoyed the first one better with the dragon. So I'm looking forward to see what the third one is going to do to me. It's called Eternal Flame. Is that not a little religion in this series? I don't remember. It's been a while since I watched any gameplay of my brain doesn't work. There was something with the Eternal Flame in the games, and I think it was some kind of religion, but I don't remember, so it's gonna be exciting. So this was my update. I have just gotten a new bed, which I'm in love with. I want it forever, though it tried to kill me, so that's another thing. But otherwise I'm cleaning a bit of it up in my apartment. I'm almost done, so that's all good thing. I just taking a break to edit some video and drawing some drawings. I'm trying a new editing program a friend recommended to me, and for now I'm liking it, but I'm still a bit confused, so I think I'll switch between the one I use currently and this new one until I get the hang of the new one. So, yeah, I will see you guys later.
Hello, it's like it's Saturday around midday soon. I've been awake since like 6 a.m. so yeah, that was fun, especially on a weekend. But I have basically not really been doing that much for the day. I have been reading a little bit in Daughters of Envy, and I'm over halfway, and still enjoying that one. I do wish though that I'm finished really soon, because I have so many others I want to start with and I want to read. But if I'm lucky, I can at least get almost to the finish line this weekend. Would be nice. Then I've been reading or listening to bit more of the Stormcrow. I'm over halfway there. I think I only need like 13 chapters left, and then I'm done with that one, and I'm still very much enjoying it. So I'm looking forward to see where it goes and ends, and yeah. Hello! So it's the end of the month, and I'm going to end it by saying that I have finished a book. Yay! Because, oh my god, I didn't think that I would finish a book this month. I was so certain that I wouldn't do it, but I did it. I finished Daughters of Envy a week after I said I would finish it that weekend. And
I did it, and I really, really liked this book. I'm looking forward to the sequel, who comes out next year. And I gave this one 4 out of 5 stars. I will say it's not a big 4 stars, because there were some things I didn't like. There were some things I was a little bit confused about. It was a little bit slow in the beginning, but overall I enjoyed the characters, the atmosphere, and the religion and all that stuff, and the magic system, and it was so cool. I'm looking forward to see where this story goes. But I'm still reading Sword of Destiny. I'm almost done with the third short story, and it's really fun. I'm really enjoying myself with this one. Then I only have 3 short stories left in the book, and then I'm done. And then I can get to the main series, which I wanted to get to for so long now. So I'm really looking forward to that. I also need to find something else to read after The Daughters of Henry, but I haven't quite decided yet what I want to do. There's a series I want to continue with, but I think I have to reread the first book in order to remember what happened and stuff like that. So I'm considering doing that. I have also another series I want to continue on, but I have to reread the 2 first books, which I don't mind because, oh my god, I love those books. I will see what I'm going to do the next month. I will just came in to say that thank you for watching if you want. You're watching. Like or dislike if you want. You can subscribe for more and hopefully better content. And I will see you guys later. Bye!